morning class. So today we're going to work on improving our writing a little bit by learning how to use evidence to support a claim. So first of all, can someone tell me what a claim is? Yes?
Claim is something that is true.
Exactly. So a claim is a position on something. It takes a side on something and says that it's true. So right now, can you look down at your whiteboards and write an example of a claim? It could really be anything, but it has to say that something is true and assert something is true. So Jessica, can you share your example?
How about it's important to make our recess period longer?
I love that. Great. So let's go with it. Why is it important to make our recess period longer?
Because it's better for our health and will help us focus more in class.
Exactly. So that's a really good claim because it says that two things about recess are true. It says that recess is healthy for us and that it helps us focus more. So look back down at the claim you wrote on your whiteboard and talk to your partner and make sure that your claim says something true, that it has a truth in it. Great. So now that we have defined a claim and set an example for ourselves, we'll talk about evidence. So evidence proves a claim to be true. Evidence really supports the claim and shows beyond just stating it that the claim is true. So look down at the claim that you wrote again and think about whether someone might look at this claim, read your claim, and think, well, that seems to be true, but I'm not really sure until I see or hear a little bit more about that claim. Nod your head if that sounds like that could be right. Okay, so now we're going to talk a little bit about different kinds of evidence that can help prove a claim to be true. So the first kind of evidence we can use is numbers. Can you think of different kinds of evidence through numbers that we can use? Yeah.
Statistics?
Exactly, statistics.
Graphs.
Graphs, perfect. So that kind of evidence would be really great to use in writing because it breaks up the words with a little bit of numbers. So that would be really nice. So look back at your claim that you wrote on your whiteboard and write down an example of a made-up statistic that you could use to help prove that claim. Great. So our next kind of evidence is research evidence. So that would be like an article that you find in a book or online, and you can use that article in your writing by quoting it or taking a fact from it and putting it in your writing. So take a moment, turn to your partner, and talk about a kind of article that you could use to help support your claim. So a kind of article that we could use in that recess example would be an article that says something about how recess is really beneficial because it helps break up the time during school day of class time and helps students kind of release energy and be focused when they return to class. And I would use a quote from that article in an essay or a letter to help prove that claim. And then our last kind of evidence is experience evidence. So that would be in the form of like a story or an example from your personal life or a testimony from like a credible source that would help show more clearly why your claim is true. So again, look at the claim you wrote on your whiteboard and raise your hand if you can think of an example from your personal life that would prove that claim. If you've already thought of it, raise your hand. So, to recap, show me on your fingers, how many different types of evidence we can use to support a claim? Exactly, three, right? So that would be numbers, research, and experience. So now what I'd like you to do is go home and for homework, use the claim you wrote on your whiteboard and the three different examples, one for numbers, one for research, and one from experience, to write a letter or a paper on why your claim is true using the evidence to prove it. All right, so we're going to learn a little cheer to help remember the different kinds of evidence we can use to support claims. So just repeat after me. Claims are nice and true, but prove your claims you need to do.
Claims are nice and true, but prove your claims you need to do.
Prove your claims through evidence to have people follow you.
Prove your claims through evidence to have people follow you.
Numbers, stats and graphs, research quotes in your paragraphs.
Numbers, stats and graphs, research quotes in your paragraphs.
Experience and testimonies will set you on the path.
Experience and testimonies will set you on the path.
All right, we're gonna do it all again together. One, two, three.
Claims are nice and true, but prove your claims you need to do. Prove your claims through evidence to have people follow you. Numbers, stats and graphs, research quotes in your paragraphs. Experience and testimonies will set you on the path.